वंदे गुरुपद्द्वंद्वं भक्तबिंदसमन्वितं श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितं श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयं गोपीजन समायुक्तं वृंदावन मनोहरम वांछाकल्पतरुवश्च कृपा सिंधुवश पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवं वृंदावि तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशव सच स्नभक्तिपदेवी सत्वत्वी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरे संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेशे गौरीयपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरु भक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरुणो धैयं सदा परिभवग्नमविष्टदोहं तीर्थास्पदं शिव विरिञ्चिनुतं शरण्यं भीतातिहं पनुतपालभवद्विपूतं वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दं यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमनि छटाय विश्वर्जित किमपि गोपवधू स्वदर्शी पूर्णानुरागरस सागर सारमूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा कृपा करोषि श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। अजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदातु संकेतनैकवितरौ कमलायताक्षौ विशाम्बरौ द्विजवरौ युगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत प्रिय करो करुणावतारो हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। नमामि गंगे तव पादपंकजं सुरासुरैर्वन्दितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानां गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापम् गौरी निरंतर विभूषि तवाम भागम नारायणो प्रियमनंगो मदापहारम वरानुजिपुरपति भजवीशनाथम वागीशजस्व वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्व च वक्षसि यस्यास्ते हृदये संबी पं निशिंगमहं भजे। हरे कृष्ण Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare. Abhisriti Krishna Padar Vinda Yor Khinoti Abhadrani Chasantanoti Satasya Suddhim Paramata Bhaktim Gyananca Virag Gyananca Bhakti Virag Yuktam Abhisriti Krishna Padar Vinda Yor Khinoti Abhadrani Chasantanoti Satasya Suddhim Paramata Bhaktim Gyananca Vigyana Virag Yuktam Gaudiya Goshtipati Gauriya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, with a feeling of superiority, with a feeling of superiority, if I think that you all are inferior to me, in that case I can get an inspiration to insult others, to look down upon others. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagadguru told, with a feeling of superiority, if I think that you all are inferior to me, in that case I can get an inspiration to insult others. That is the tragedy. Actually, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, continuous remembrance of Supreme Lord, Guru Vaishnava, Dham, Nam, is called purity. It is called actual purity. Continuously, to remember continuously about Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, Dham, Nam, everything, it is called actually purity. External purity, though in sadhak dasa we like to maintain, it's a must. But actually purity can, we can attain purity through our continuous touch with Supreme Lord, Guru, Vaishnava, everything. That is the main thing. Purity means, you know, mantra, you know, always you are taking manasnan mentally. Mentally you are taking snan to purify yourself. All the time we should remember Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. The moment we forget Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, in that case Kali can get chance to enter into your body to, you know, put you in problem. Kali always searching opportunity how to apavitra va pavitra va sarva avasthagato viva jasvaretu kan pundarikvakshan jasvaretu pundarikvakshan sabha yavantaram suchihi. In this mantra, manasnan mantra is written that apavitra va pavitra va, any condition and the pure and impure, any condition, but actual purity, always when I am going to remember Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan Dham Nam, then apavitra apavitra sarva avastha gato viva jas maretu pundarik aksham sab ayyamantaram suchi. So internally and externally I can purify myself. Antare vahire samavyavahar amani manodahabo, it is also purity. Because I think I am inferior to all, everybody, all, whole world, when I am looking, when I am, many times I told, because due to Maya, you cannot remember. When I can think, when I can see, when I can think, when I can do anything in relation to Supreme Lord, if I can see the whole world in relation to Supreme Lord, then I can feel I am inferior to everybody. This is the actual purity actually. Tinado Visuni Yvab can bring purity inside your heart, otherwise there is no other way. No other way. So Abhisriti, this slok also speaking, Abhisriti Krishna Padara Vindyar Chinoti Abhadrani. Maybe some Abhadrani, some anartha, some bad things are there. But this sloka speaking, Abhisriti Krishna Padara Vindyar Chinoti Abhadrani Chasamtanoti. Automatically, if I go on thinking about Supreme Lord, if I can get the scope, then automatically some abhadra, I mean bad things, can go away. I can eliminate all bad things from heart by sadhu sangha, by harikatha, but I cannot do. Why I cannot do? Because this is all the toxic result of wrong teachings I received. Received by you before. This all are the toxic result of wrong teachings received by you before. In your life before you have received, maybe today also secretly you are getting also sangha, who can say? So this can be the result of this can be the toxic result of wrong teachings received by you before. This is the result. Otherwise, when I am hearing Harikatha continuously, why you are in problem? Why sometime accident happen? Because you violate. You violate my request. When I am speaking, continuously you should do Harinam, Sankirtan, or if you cannot do, you can play Kirtan, everything, all the time. Because it is the Siddhanta of Prabhupada, if there is actual Harikatha, if there is actual Kirtan, there cannot be any problem. There cannot happen any danger, any problem, cannot happen. You can remember, long before, maybe 2-3 months before, I told you that Prabhupada went to some place to speak Harikatha, then suddenly, information coming to Prabhupada that one small boy, 5 years boy, he fall inside fire. There was fire, the boy, you know, somehow. And the Prabhupada speaking, there cannot be any danger. Because Harikatha going on now, you go and check up, there cannot be any problem. Then everybody going there and find the boy is fine. They find the boy is totally fine, no problem. But you forget my request. Continuously you will have to play Harikatha, Harikirtan, or you can sing Harinam. Then any kind of danger coming cannot come. You can pass away, but you cannot obey. What to do? That's why problem coming. So you see, Prabhupada speaking, the contamination is that. Contamination when can come? When I am thinking that I am superior to everybody. I am superior to everybody, all. So then in that case, I can try to insult others because they are inferior to me. The superiority complex, it is called. So this way, I can develop impurity, otherwise the sarup of jiva, there is no impurity. In the sarup of jiva, there is no impurity, not at all. Only because of maya, we are doing all wrong activities like ghost. So we are going to buy or we are going to invite impurity inside your heart. No other way. It cannot so happen. You can remember, actually, material people, even those who are doing bhajan with some false ego, I told, devils can also quote scriptures. I can show Ravan speaking Harikatha, I mean quotation from scripture, Hiranyakashipu speaking. So what? No use, because they have contamination in their heart. They are, you know, always against Guru Vaishnava. Prabhupada speaking, the main contamination, Prabhupada speaking, it is the Siddhanta Prabhupada. The main contamination is that inside their heart, if you search, you can find they are against pure Guru Vaishnava. That is actual contamination inside them. But they cannot feel that we are contaminated. Prabhupada speaking, if we are inside our heart, if there is some opposite, if we are against pure Guru Vaishnava, if we are doing all against Guru Vaishnava, purity, Siddhanta, everything, it is called impurity, all wrong activities, which is against Shastra, Shastriya Siddhanta. It's called impurity. Impurity is nothing which can, impurity is nothing but which can stop your bhajan, which can bring your consciousness down. Which can bring your consciousness down, this is called impurity. Nothing else. It's a scientific explanation of impurity. Actually, really so. If we can go to forest, if we can go to dense forest, if we can catch one ferocious animal, we can catch and come out of forest. We can try to train that animal. So we can go to forest, we can bring the animal out of the forest. But it is quite impossible. Our mind is one kind of forest. Our mind is one kind of dense forest of anartha, where all big animals, ferocious animals stay. So it is quite impossible to take that animal out of mind and throw outside. Follow what I mean to say. It is very easy, we can go to forest, dense forest, and catch one, we can catch one ferocious animal, somehow we trap and bring that animal out of the forest. But it is quite, this can so happen. But it is quite impossible to throw the animal there inside my mind. It is quite impossible to throw that animal out of mind to make the mind free. It's impossible. We are not actually doing Guru Vaishnava Sangha. Quite impossible. If at all I am doing Guru Vaishnava Sangha, that kind of mood can never come. You are speaking all rubbish. How it is possible? You are doing Sadhu Sangha. If I am at all doing Sadhu Sangha, where it is written that Labhamatya Sadhu Sangha Sarva Siddhi Hoy, 1 second divided by 11 is equal to some fraction of second, which is more than enough to cut my Maya. But I am in Maya. How possible? You are speaking you are doing satsanga, but I think no. I am sure that you are not doing appropriate satsanga. Satsanga mean, Jiva Goswami is speaking, inevitable result you can get. Satsanga mean it's a life-saving medicine, 100%. But we are actually not doing satsanga. We are acting that we are going to show that we are satsanga, we are doing satsanga. But actually we are not doing. If satsanga, if I doing, then what is the result? What Prabhupada speaking, phalena phala karanam anumiyate. The result of your character, behavior can prove that you are doing satsanga. The more you can do satsanga, the more you can develop humble attitude. Prabhupada speaking, sometime, Prabhupada speaking clearly, sometime we like to prove that we are in line with Guru Vaishnava. We are doing Bani Seva. Right you are. Sometime Bani Seva is one kind of poison for you. Because you cannot digest Bani Seva. Like Raganuga Bhakta. Bhaktivinoda was speaking, if you are suffering from a big disease, your liver disorder or everything disorder, Bhaktivinoda speaking, if you are a patient, very very weak patient, if some foolish people going to give you rich food, very very rich food, then what will happen? Bhaktivinoda speaking, A patient should be served, a patient should be served with suitable prasadam, suitable fruits, so that no problem can happen. Because he has no digestion power. He cannot, it can make more and more problem. Even he can die. Because gas, you know, gas acidity can go up to such a level. I have seen in my own life. One young, you know, brahmachari. Now he is married. He was totally unconscious for 4-5 hours. Our acharya called me, Maharaj, look the case. Maybe some ghost, taking over him. Control over him, I think. So I come, I am watching, and with Nishinga Mantra, some mantra, I am giving water, but no change. Then I told him, to my acharya, to our acharya, at present acharya, that no, it is not actually ghost. Then what can happen? After that, one doctor was called. He came, he checked up, and taking information, the case history, what he done previous night, what he took. Then we take information, then the, you know, Bhandari speaking, he took so much gugni, so much rich thing, and gas and acidity coming such a level, the poor totally faint, we cannot respond, like dump and dip, like ghost, you know, peasant. Then he was given medicine, cold water, all with, we are putting water, cold water on his head, for half an 1 hour, then he is going to open eyes, 1 or 2 hours after, acidity. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if you are patient, you are suffering from indigestion itself, if somebody is going to give you rich food, then what will happen? You are going to die. Without treatment, that brahmachari was supposed to die. But some, by luckily, by the mercy of Dauji Mandir in Vrindavan, it happened. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those who are patient, they should take diet. Their diet should be suitable for their health. Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking about Raganuga Bhakti. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those who are patient, they are full of kama, anartha. If they are going to think, hear about, you know, Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga, all the secret lila of Radha Govinda, 100% they can either imitate and die, become sahajya, they can fall down, 100% there is no doubt. Bhaktivinoda Thakur can never speak lie. They are all Sadhu Guru Vaishnav, they are speaking out of their own feelings. They are never making any drama. Don't try to think. So if you want to claim that I am doing Sadhu Sangha, I can speak loudly. I can speak loudly. Who is doing my Sangha? Who was with me for the past 15 years he gone outside? To wrong Siddhanta, mana all Asha Sangha. Asked external people singing, he is staying with Sambhava. But I am 100, I can touch Bhagavat and speak. He is not staying with me. Staying with me means to stay with all my Siddhanta, Vichar, efficacy, everything. It is not drama. But he gone, fall down. So many devotees, so-called devotees, staying with Prabhupada, they all fall down. They leave Prabhupada. They accept the lotus feet of some other guru, Kanu Priya Baba, everything. But still, we are so foolish, we cannot understand. We are actually not doing satsanga. If at all I am doing satsanga, then result can speak. Result of satsanga can show us, actually we are not doing satsanga. So it's very typical. With some anartha, you can do satsanga. It's not a big problem. But with kapatata, with some duplicity, you want to enjoy the name and fame of Guru Vishnu, it is more than poison. Prabhupada speaking, is more than poison. If I like to keep some desire inside, that I can get some reputation that I was with Prabhupada, I was with Bhaktivinoda Thakur. If I like to take undue advantage of the thing, this secret thing, this you know, I can discuss about, you know, aparat, anartha, everything on details, I like to discuss. I don't know time can permit or not, so many things to speak. So actually, Prabhupada speaking, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, sometime with some desire inside, with some duplicity, we want to take the advantage of name, fame, position of that Vaishnava, famous Vaishnava. We are going to show that we are doing satsanga, but I am is not at all doing satsanga. Like many times before I told, in front of Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj, Prabhupada speaking, in front of our Paramahansa Acharya Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj, so many people used to stay around him. They always wanted to prove that we are staying with Gaur Kishore Babaji, Paramahansa Siddha Mahatma. They wanted to enjoy name, fame, position, money, opulence, everything. But Prabhupada speaking, my Guru Padma Paramahansa Sesto, externally, my Guru Padma Paramahansa Sesto, Srila Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj, externally never wanted to throw them out. Never wanted to throw them out externally. But internally, Babaji Maharaj never accepted them. Follow what I say. Babaji Maharaj never accepted them from heart. That's why they are always fallen. That is the secret Siddhanta we are speaking for 2 days. You know, this is the secrecies. Who can say who is doing Guru Seva? Who can say that who is enjoying full kripa of Guru Vishnu? Who can say? You can deserve, I am doing Bani Seva, so I am enjoying. Who can say? Secretly the kripa going to some other. Follow? So we should not have any false ego. We should not demand that I am doing Bani Seva, because that Bani Seva can be, that Bani Seva can act as a poison in your life, because you have some anartha. Anartha already there. And at the same time, you want to jump in your bhajan from this place to Raganuga bhajan. This has been your, you know, chronic disease all along. And I am going to give some treatment by the mercy of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. If you are going to do wrong activities like heartless people, inhuman activities, people can say that it is a teaching of Maharaj. Those who are experienced people, they cannot never speak that way. That's very bad. I never approved that kind of, you know. So all the time, if we are going to do Guru Vaishnava Seva, first of all, we should try to cut our anartha. There should not be any duplicity. That is the main impediment. With duplicity, if we like to prove that I am staying with pure Guru Vaishnava, this, that, so I can name some name and fame very shortly. Even after his death, I can give. This is very dangerous. Prabhupada speaking, this Siddhanta, if sometime we are going to utilize the name, fame and position of that pure Guru Vaishnava, in that case, we can automatically get deviated from the track of Guru Vaishnava and we can fall down. Prabhupada speaking, why, you know, sometime it happens so, very secretly, knowingly or unknowingly, they have some desire to utilize the name fame of Guru Vaishnava, this, that. In that case, they automatically get deviated from the track of previous Acharya. They can follow their separate rules and regulation. You know. Otherwise it is not possible. Previous Acharya, if I find present Acharya going to follow the same track, All Siddhanta Vichar, all efficacy, all Bhava, Bhajan procedure, everything, then how it is possible can he get deviated from that? It cannot so happen. If he is going to follow his previous Acharya, then it is not possible. And also we can never expect any kind of fault. We cannot expect any kind of fault in the life of any perfect Acharya. Acharya is not such a thing. So we cannot expect any kind of anartha, any kind of defects, any kind of faults in the life of one Acharya. Because in the life of Acharya, there is nothing except Bhagavad Seva. Prabhupada speaking, in the whole life of Acharya, in the whole devotional life of Acharya, we can see very closely, we can find nothing except Bhagavad Seva. In the unique character and, you know, lifestyle of Acharya, there is nothing except Bhagavad Seva, Guru Vaishnava Seva, nothing. So if I am staying one Acharya who is doing Acharan, how it is possible that I can develop some wrong thing? Maybe secretly I am doing some satsanga. Because otherwise how possible? Satsanga going to show its result, inevitable result. Like knowingly, unknowingly, if you are going to get a satsanga, you can get result of that. Like poison, without any information, without anything, unknowingly if you take, poison can show own result. Similarly, asatsanga, if you are with that kind of mentality, that I am doing satsanga, but I can also do asatsanga. Secretly, I can go through Gopi Baba, this, that, keep on Acharya's photo to respect him. Externally, you are respecting me. Internally, you are paying. Like, you know, like the case, you know, Indra was very angry. You know, Indra was very angry. I saw, no, that, you know, that Acharya, when Brihaspati was upset to see the behavior of Indra, Brihaspati gone, Antadhyan vanish, Brihaspati vanish. Then all demigods are in problem, they are crying, Gurudev were gone, Gurudev gone. Adrishyatam gataha. Adrishya, vanish. Then they took decision to go to Vishwarup to request him to act as Acharya. But one secret thing I like to remind you, that Vishwarup was very powerful, but Vishwarup was secretly, while he was doing, you know, yagya in the fire, oblation, you know, going to ghee. You know, in the name of demigods and everything, but secretly he was offering in the name of Asura. Indra Maharaj could detect it very, very angry. Hey, my God, he's doing secretly, he's giving the offer to demigods, then open the sword and cut the, you know, heads. There was no one head, there was, you know, three heads, all gone. This way, there was one big anartha, I mean, Brahmahatya. So if you are going to follow me 100%, then you can follow. If you like, if you think that I am 100%, I am trying my best to, then you can. I cannot allow if you follow me 60%, if you can follow me 50%, and 50% you can kick me, 50% you can kick me mentally, that I cannot allow. I cannot allow. I can throw you out. I am not Sahajya. I can throw you out. If I find this kind of mentality, secretly you are doing, you want to become gopi very quickly. Otherwise how? How it is possible to show this kind of attitude? I can go back to Gita sloka. Dhayato vishyanapung sang sangasteshu upajayate sangyat sangyat kamaha kamat krodo avijayate kamat krodo avijayate If you are not going to fulfill your desire, secret desire, passive kaam, then you become angry. Kamat krodho vyate krodhat bhavati shanmaha shanmohat siti vibhams siti vibhamsat buddhinasa buddhinasat pranasami. You can go down and down, down this way. If you follow me 100%, then there can be no problem. So Prabhupada speaking, if somebody going to follow Guru Vaishnava externally, internally some desire there, I mean some duplicity there, they want to use their name fame, they automatically get deviated. And I already told, passive calm is more dangerous than active calm. Passive calm you cannot see, but it is like one kind of explosion. By your character, pure Guru Vaishnava can detect. It, one kind of explosion is secretly there. You know, like Prabhupada used to say, that Hayagir Brahmachari is volcanic eruption. Volcanism is so energy. It is, don't take it wrong way, but this example can I use it in negative way. Negative mean to give you an impression about how passive karma can act in your life to throw you out of bhajan. One time your karma coming inside your heart, angry attitude, then all your previous bhajan can go down. You can lose your power. You don't know. Impossible. If you somehow develop angry attitude, karma, because your angry attitude means out of karma. If one Vaishnava people angry, it is not out of karma. It is not out of karma. But if you become angry, surely it is out of karma. Then in that case problem, it can put you, throw you out of bhajan. So Dayato Vishayanabhundi, you should understand this point. So passive karma is more dangerous than active karma. We cannot expect this kind of thing. Impossible. Kishudas Kobiraj Goswami, that's why with humble mood going to express in front of us is very humble mood. But who is going to learn? Everybody likes to maintain his own helem, position. Ah, I am this, I am that. Everybody. Nobody like to come down to Tinadapi level. They think it is derogatory. Why we should go down? Guru Maharaj used to laugh and speak this point. I wanted to become Vaishnava, but when I come across with this word, Tinadapi, oh, it is impossible for. It is impossible for me to become Vaishnava. Guru Maharaj used to say in Bengali, he used to laugh and say, Baba, Tinadapi, Baba, Vaishnav habo chilo mone boro shad. There was, I was fostering this kind of desire that someday I can become Vaishnav. When I come across with this word, oh my God, I will have to become there. No, it is not possible. I can show so many exhibition, but I cannot become Trinadapi. Not possible. Bas Krishna Das Kobiraj Goswami, Vrindavan Das, all our previous Guru Varga, or even Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada, our previous Guru Varga, all Gauriya, they are all Trinadapi. Because without Trinadapi, you cannot come out successful in your way. Impossible. Impossible. You cannot come out successful. So, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami used to speak, Vaigunna Kita Kalita Paishunna Brahma Purita Dainar nabe nimagna hamsi chaitanya vaidyam asraye. The great, doctor, Ayurvedic doctor, chaitanya vaidyam asraye, spiritual doctor. Vaigunna kita kalito. There is so much, rubbish qualities are there inside me. All like asura. Those rakshas and asura, they can have that kind of quality. Vaigunna kita kalito, apaishunna brono prito. I develop that kind of, poison, in my cheeks. It's called. So, vaigunna kita kalito, apaishunna brono prito. It is infection on cheeks. So in young age you can find some infection come, and in cheeks develop some, you know. It is called Vaigunno Kitokulito. It is like, you know, insect which is cutting, which is going to cutting off the, you know, all my good qualities inside my heart. Vaigunno Kitokulito. Paishunno Vrunabhuta. I am developing beast-like quality. We cannot expect this kind of quality from a Vaishnava. How possible? We can never expect. I think you are intoxicated by Maya. Like, you know, people, those who are drinking so much wine and, you know, charas, heroin, brown sugar, they are developed. They cannot understand what is happening. I think you are in this kind of. Actual bhajan cannot throw you out of bhajan. Actual mode of bhajan, if you follow, 100% I can give guarantee in Vyasasana. 100%, if you are following 100% perfect bhajan, there is no possibility. At least you should develop Saranagati 100%. I can discuss this point also. Before that, I like to touch another point. You can know where Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, I am developing that kind of beastly conception. Inhuman activities I am developing. So this can prove that you are not doing satsanga. Because fraction of second satsanga can give you the topmost secret of Krishna Prema. I am not speaking, it's the Siddhanta of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur Guruvar. Lava Matta Sadhu Sangha Sarva Siddhi Hai, meaning Krishna Prema also you can get. But you are not getting. What to speak about Krishna? You cannot eliminate your anartha from inside. You cannot get adjusted. You cannot get adjusted with. You cannot laugh. When I was in, you know, infant class, then I read, very small boy. That time I read, the best quality of a man is to develop friendship relation with other, manuske balavasa, to love others. When I was very infant, very small, manuske balavasa hi holo ashol dharma. Very small age I read. Now I can remember. If I cannot love you, you can make some drama, you can automatically feel. 100% I challenge. If I love you all, you can feel some reaction, though you are thousands of miles away from me, 100%. You can feel Mara Lavas from heart. Because love is such a delicate thing, such a sweet thing, such a sensitive thing, that even a dog, you can come to my Goshala, I can show you. If I go to in front of Gomata, they'll start licking my, you know, chest. I kiss them, lick them, you know, they try to lick me. They understand, they love me. So even one dog, if I love, the dog can realize that the man love me. But if you are going to misunderstand me, what I can do? So this is the tragedy, you see. This is the main thing I learned when I was very small, that to love others is the main quality you should develop. Now I tally with this spiritual knowledge, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also going to teach the same thing. A pure sadhu can embrace the whole world. There is no friend and foe conception. Then everything is friend, is foe, is one kind of selfishness. If you are going to develop selfishness day by day in the name of bhajan and guru seva, bani seva, then you can get deviated from the track of pure Guru Vaishnava. Automatically. Nobody can protect you. Because aparad, where you are doing, Guru Maharaj used to say, Maharaj, one brahmachari fall down from the third floor of Kesighat building. That time I was there, long ago, 25 years back. I was there. And that Brahmachari somehow was reading some Vyakaran book in the rooftop. That time he was almost sleeping. And one big monkey coming and take away the Vyakaran book from him. Going to cut the Vyakaran, he get up. He going to chase that monkey. Monkey going to throw that Vyakaran book, going to chase him. Oh, fearful condition. Monkey going to cut him. Then he going down, back. There was no sufficient, you know, pillar. Then he was also tall man. Then you go down from Jugal Kishar Mandir, from, you know, is there. Luckily, in the Jugal Kishar Mandir, there was one slab, you know, sunset. He first fall down from that, you know, roof, and first he fall down on the, you know, on the, you know, sunset. Then he fall down on the stone. If directly he is going to fall down, then, you know, spot dead. After that, all Brajavasi coming. Baba, Baba, come. You know, sadhu, he fall. Where? What happens? I was writing something inside. I come down, you see. Hari Ram Ram, he fall down. Oof, full of blood. Then all Brajavasi help us. Then we get one car. Immediately go to Methodist hospital in almost near Mathura. They say reject. We cannot take this case. And we go, you can go to Delhi or Mathura. Mathura, we take one car and take some loan from some brahmachari in, that Gauriamat, from, you know, Kesavji Gauriamat, from there, and go directly to, what I mean to say. I mean, there actually, after treatment, doctor speaking with full exclamation is, now he is out of order after 2-3 days in coma. Because Maharaj, it was the arrangement of Supreme Lord, I don't know. 0.001 millimeter, if the impact is going deep into the brain, nobody can save him. But by chance, there were double monkey cap. Double monkey cap on his head. So this way, nobody can save us. If I, you know, this is the situation, you see. You know, Guru Vaishnava always try to save us in any condition. If in that condition, if I like to throw him, okay, let him die. If I throw him in Kasighat, I can get contaminated by his blood. Then who? I am not a man. But to speak about sadhu. That day I was speaking, na? Without attaining the stage of humanity, without attaining the stage of humanity, how I can become sadhu? All foolish people all around, they have no common sense. Without attaining the platform of humanity, how I can become sadhu? There is no humanity, nothing. I become sadhu. How possible? It's possible. But whole people, they are going to be cheated. They think red cloth means God. Sannyas means God. We should pay salute. Oh, Maharaj, Dandavad. Ah. Pay prostrate Dandavad. They don't know it's a condition, fallen condition of that sannyasi. So what I mean to say, I'm never going to teach you to insult people. I wanted to speak you about what Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada told. Nothing else. I never teach you to insult others. If you insult me, you can say I am very silent. If you insult Guru Varga, you can say I can jump like a dog. You can try to insult me and see what a reaction coming inside my heart. I can feel nothing. Okay, they are insulting me. I should be insulted. That's why they are insulting. But if you insult Guru Vaishnava, I cannot allow. I cannot. No. So this way, Guru Ma speaking, finally, doctor speaking, his brain out of order. Though he is living, actually, the problem out, he is out of problem, but he gone mad. Then somehow I buy special ticket, I take that man. Previously I was giving so many treatment to the man. You can, who can give you, you know, by the order of Guru Maharaj, Guru Maharaj speaking, Maharaj, Baba, you should serve him because he can die. It is my seva. Maharaj, you need not speak. Surely I can do. I was cleaning his stool, urine, you know, there by cathedral cap, there was, you know, developing some, you know, poisonous infection. Poison in by cathedral, you know, that, you know, cap was there in his penis, here, there, so many. Infection. Doctor told me, Maharaj, you will have to apply medicine. So I closed room, used to apply medicine, everything, like one child. Mother giving child. This way, by the desire of Guru Maharaj, by the instruction of Guru Maharaj, I developed this kind of, or many such cases. Not Satyagominda Maharaj, another Prabhu was there in Chaitanya Gauriya Math. Yes, Grihastha, but later he took red cloth from Bhakti Vallabhtitu and was staying. He was previously doing service in TB center. He was old man, he developed cancer, totally. You know, Rishikesh Maharaj, that time in charge of Chaitanya Gauriya Math, giving Bhava, Prabhu, you will have to give treatment. Okay, I can give. This way I developed that kind of, by the teachings of Guru Maharaj and Guru Varga, I learned this. And you are learning something from a separate group. Already you, because this kind of your behavior, this is all, you know, the toxic result of your wrong teachings received by you before. It is not my teachings. I can never teach that way. So Guru Maharaj, when I finally, devotees, they took decision that Shyamal Krishna should go to Mayapur with that patient. Somehow I go fast here. So much trouble, you cannot even imagine. I go to Chaitanya Gauriya Math, they give me one separate room in fourth floor. There I always arrange his water, prasadam, everything. He is crazy, going to break the room, everything. I am controlling. Finally, we arrange one car and go to Mayapur. Then in Mayapur, he was showing crazy attitude, speaking all rubbish against me. All devotees, they are trying to give water on his head. He is speaking all rubbish, slag language. Then finally, Guru Maharaj hearing from room, Baba, who is speaking all rubbish language then? Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, that devotee gone mad, he is speaking. Oh, he is doing aparad. You know, aparad, how Maharaj? You know, he is gone out of, you know, Amyo Krishna, I forget the name. Ashit Krishna, yes, I forget, I remember. Ashit Krishna is from Bangladesh. Very intelligent boy. But now, Guru Maharaj speaking, I say, Maharaj, he is gone out of what has been. But Baba, aparad done knowingly, unknowingly, he had to suffer the result. Pap, if there is sinful activities, it related with material body and, you know. But aparad is related with Atma. Big problem. So if aparad, how you can understand aparad? If aparad is there, then you can realize there is consciousness going down. You cannot do Harinam properly. You have losing your interest to do satsanga, that's in aparad. So from aparad, Guru Maharaj used to say, aparad, if aparad is done any Vaishnava or Vaishnavi, you will have to beg for pardon from there. If he is going to excuse you from heart, okay, because Vaishnavi always merciful. Oh, Vaishnava also merciful, okay. Let the thing happen, this kind of, in material world, this kind of things can happen. Oh, okay. But finally, I am going to put one, you know, resolution, that if you, a second, you know, if any, and a second time if you are going to, then I can throw you out. Three times, first, second, third, this third time. If I find this kind of, I can throw out. I never mind. I don't care who is going to do Bhani Seva. I am less interested. We are doing Bani Seva, we sneak down. It is the duty of Nityananda. Who am I? You can stop your Bani Seva and see. I am going to, you know, speak something. It is your. It is your privilege. You are going to do. If after doing Seva, if you see, I have done so many Seva, so many, you know, translations, so many, then it is not Seva. Be careful. When after doing Seva, if I am doing to do Seva, Prabhupada and Guru Maharaj, if I say, I have done so much Seva, who could know Guru Maharaj? I was the first person wanted to give Harikatha internet, then everybody could know it. Who is going to know that Vaishnava? This offensive, you know, offensive remark. If I say I have done so many things for me, everybody hearing Harikatha, it's offensive. It's offensive, you can throw. You can throw your seva and check what is the desire of Nityananda all around. Don't speak that way. So with humble attitude, humble mood, we are doing seva to get benefit. It is not the interest of Guru Vaishnava. They are less interested about name, fame and position. So you are declaring that I have done this much seva, so everybody knowing it. Okay. If you think so, it is okay. But this is not seva. After doing seva, if I am not going to develop more and more humble attitude, humble mood, this cannot be called as seva. Seva means satisfaction inside the heart can come. The more I can do, more desires, I like to get more satisfaction with seva. Still today I am not said, I like to do more seva. There is no burning condition. This kind of, you know, if you are going to lose your patience, if you are going to lose your patience, if you are going to develop angry attitude, if you are going to develop some hatred for woman, this, that, that means you are deviated from the track of Sadguru. Only and only, Prabhupada speaking, I am not speaking. Prabhupada speaking, only and only then, when I am deviated from the track of Guru Vaishnava, only and only then you can find some problem in me. I am losing my patience, I am losing my temperament, I become angry. Otherwise, when your mind and heart resting unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, how it is possible that you can lose your patience? Whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing Bhajan Das, everything in details. You know? Bhikkhu jano katileo kishuna boloi, sukaiya moile kare panina mangoi, jeija mange tare dei apandhan, gharma vishti swahe aner kore rakshan. Krishna also speaking in front of friends in Vrindavan forest. Oh, Esham Baram Janmo, oh friends, you see those trees and creepers. They are actually very nice life. They only have taken the resolution of seva. Only. They have taken vow to do seva only. In return, they never. You ask something to some devotee, what you need. Charity begins at home. You ask your children. You ask your wife that you need something, I can arrange something. Eh? You can think in your mind. Never you bother. They can expect something from you. You will have to fulfill their heart. This is called loving, loveful exchange. Then how you can develop your, you know, thoughts, impossible. You are less interested about other. Then people also can. If I am going to show some sickness, then you can also throw me. Sambhavi is now contaminated. Hari, idiot. He can throw me. I am very careful about that so that I cannot take help from you. I am very careful about that. And speaking the example of Madhavendrapuri Vishwar Puriba, they are passing stool and urine, you know. Still, Vishwar Puriba with loveful heart, serving. Loveful heart. That's why they are getting Tattva Gyan. It's not so cheap thing. I can give you Ujjal Nilmuni and you can go on, you can become gopi, foolish number one. You know, contamination of your, you know, conception, going to give this kind of result. It's not good, I cannot allow, third time. You know. Now I can give example. My Guru Maharaj used to say, Mara, Baba, if somebody is doing this kind of opera, this kind, you know, pure Guru Vishnu, they can try to check him because they are never going to do criticize. If I am going to chastise you, if I am going to beat you, if I am going to, many times I beat, you know, some Guru, some Brahmachari, I don't like to speak in him, many times I slap, beat him, but she never feels, think any reaction. Oh, Maharaj beat me, okay. That kind of temperament, you know. So, you see, this kind of temperament, I like to speak that if there is, you know, no serving mood, Krishna Bhagavan speaking in Bhagavad, in Srimad Bhagavad, 10th canto, Aho Vesam Bharam Jam, whereas in Mahaprabhu also speaking, those trees and keepers always, they have taken bow to give seva. In return, they never expect anything. Bikkho jano katilo kishuna bolay, shukaiya mohile kare pani na mangay. Jei ja mangay tare dehi apan dhan, gharma vishchi sahe anir kore rakshan. The tree, one woodcutter going to cut the tree, and the sun and sunlight in a noontime going to take rest there in the shade of that tree. A tree not going to say, you are going to cut me, why you are going to take rest here? Never speaking. Okay. Briksho, one tree not going to ask for water. Give me water, I am drying for a long time. Not speaking. Briksho jano katileo kichon. When they are cutting the trees, not speaking anything. Only they have taken bow to do seva with fruits and flower, leaves, wood, or everything, whole life. So a Vaishnava, who is Vaishnava, who has taken resolution in his life to serve whole, you know, world, infinity world. Because directly, indirectly, they are going to serve infinity world. No? They never expect anything from anybody. They expect no self-interest in their life, no self-interest. Only they are doing so that all the bonded soul around the world, they can get safe position. Safe position mean to help develop consciousness, to help develop Krishna consciousness inside one jivatma. It is called paropokar. It is called best service. Paropokar. If I can do benefit, this kind of this talk. So also in Niti Shastra also, Jalani tasam na pivanti nadyaha. Jalani tasam na pivanti nadyaha. Phalani tadvad na khadanti viksha. Follow. It is written. Jalani, all the waters, they are flowing in the river. River never going to drink one drop of water. Jalani tasam na pibanti na dhyaha, phalani tadvat na khadanti vikshaha. Nadanti shasyani megaha kadachit paropukarayo satang vibhuti. If at all one sadhu getting power, big power to deliver all common, then you should not express envy attitude with him. Don't try to kill him, don't try to insult him, it's very offensive. Jalanitasam na pivanti naddha phalanitadvad na khadanti vikshaha nadanti shasyani megha kadachit paropukarayo satam vibhuti. Paropukarayo satam vibhuti. Rivers, those who are going to carry so gallons of waters, but still they are not going to drink even one drop. Jalani tasam na pivanti vikshaha. Phalani tadvad na khadanti vikshaha. a mango tree giving thousands of fruits, but never one mango tree going, never a mango tree going to take one mango or coconut tree, any fruit. The tree not going to take any fruit from his own, no, all for you and me, for Bhagavan. And shashyani crops, and the crops in the field, megha, megha mane, those clouds, they never going to deserve credit that I have given water to your field, in your field, so you are developing crops, so I need 50% share. 50% share I need, never speaking. Follow. So you should remember this sloka. Again, I can speak from Shastra also, it is not from Shastra, but Niti Shastra. So nice, you know. Jala nita sam na pibanti nadya phala nita dvad na khadanti viksha nadanti shasyani megha kadachi paropukaraya satam vibhuti paropukaraya satam vibhuti. If at all any pure sadhu guru Vaishnava Paramahansa is there, don't try to pick up enemy with him unnecessarily. Because his life is for you all. A Vaishnava, his life is for you all. Why you are going to think you are in a competitor with, you are going to open one competition with him? Don't try to do it. He has no self-interest. That's why a Vaishnava is he whose life is for you all. A Vaishnava cannot show that kind of, you know, cruel attitude. That kind of inhuman activities cannot show. Anyway, again I can give one example from Chaitanya Charitamrita. I like to speak so many things with you, but time cannot permit. That's a big problem. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking to Sanatan Gosai, Sanatan Siksha. There in front of Sanatan Goswami Pad, Mahaprabhu giving one example of one hunter. One hunter, he was very cruel. He used to hunt in a very, you know, very inhuman activities. We cannot expect. Anyway, I am not going to touch, I want to touch this point, not in detail, so many things to discuss. And Mahaprabhu going to speak this example from one Puran, Skanda Puran, and going to speak that Naraji Maharaj one day in his way to Triveni Sangam and the confluence of Ganga, Jumuna, Saraswati, Allahabad. There is, he was going through a forest. There are so many, you know, dead body, almost dead body. Not dead, fully dead, half dead. There, you know, pain, feeling pain. Then Naraji Maharaj going, and suddenly Naraji Maharaj hear one sound. Hey, don't go there. For you, I am going to miss my target. And who speaking? Naraji looking, oh, one cruel, you know, hunter. He was supposed to hunt one, you know, another target. But due to me, oh, who kill? Half, but I kill. So for you, I miss target, you know. Naraji Maharaj, you are so, oh my God, so painful. I have one request to you. Ah, you are sadhu. What request you have? If you need any skin of tiger or deer, I can give you. Come to my house. Oh, no, no, no. I am not going to take any tiger or tiger skin or anything. For bhajan, sometimes we need tiger skin. You know. And we like to sit onto the kippa of Guru Kippa. No tiger skin, nothing. It is. I can discuss someday. Go under the guidance of Guru Maharaj. Purascharan Vidhi is a must. Without Purascharan Vidhi, nobody can come out successful. But final Siddhanta, we can get Guru Seva, topmost Guru Seva, topmost Purascharan. What is Purascharan? How to do? All I can discuss under the guidance of Guru Maharaj in details. You don't know actually. And you know, if you at all know, not fully. You have no conception. So Guru Seva is complete. Guru Seva is itself complete. Sadguru Seva. Sadguru Seva, it is itself complete. Purascharan. We need not go for Purascharan. So I can discuss in detail someday. So now Naradji Maharaj actually speaking that it is my request, whenever you are going to kill the any animal, you can kill fully. Who, my God? What you can get benefit out of that? Oh ho, I am speaking, it is my request, whenever you kill any animal, please you kill fully. Don't not talk. So what profit you can get? No question of my profit. Actually, when you are going to kill half, you are going to make him half dead, then he is feeling big pain. Oh, I learned it from my father. My father speaking, always we'll have to hunt this tactics, this procedure. Because when that beast, you know, feeling pain, very heavy pain, then we are enjoying. We are enjoying very much. Oh, really? You're so cruel. Oh, actually, my father teach me. You must kill him half dead, then he is feeling pain as we are enjoying. No, it is my request. Whenever you kill, you will have to keep fully, or half you, if you kill half, is that giving big pain, and you will have to suffer this pain next life. Huh? Really so? Yes. Really? Yes. It is the scriptural analysis, Siddhanta. If you kill some prani, jivatma, you are taken. And automatically. And this kind of. So what to do? How to get? I kill so many countless, you know, beasts. So how to get respite? Naraji Maharaj, you can go, break your, you know, bow and arrow, take bath in the river and come to me, I can give you some mantra. Huh? Then how I can eat? How I can earn my bread? Oh ho, it is my responsibility. Really? Yes. I can send all rice, chapati, bread, everything to you. First you will have to break and take resolution that you cannot kill anyone. Well, I can obey you. Because they influence satsanga. Satsanga, na, Ajamil was taking satsanga when the conversation going between Yamaduta and Vishnuduta. That satsanga was sufficient for Ajamil to take resolution that I cannot waste my time anymore. I can do Hari Bhajan. Follow what I say. Then gone to do Hari Bhajan. Ajamil upyaga dhyana. Ajamil also came out successful. So that way that hunter was ready to obey Naraji Maharaj. The Naraji Maharaj then assured him that you can make one bhajan kutir here with your wife, and you can say, well, break, don't beg, don't kill anybody. Then Harinam, you know, that Naraji Maharaj went to give, and they after taking Harinam from Naraji Maharaj, what a great impact, you know, inside their heart. They are going to, you sit here and go on doing Harinam. Every day, you know, I can send rice and chapati, everything to you. Oh, really? Yes. You sit here. And they doing Harinam, really so? Every day, all, you know, everything coming. What I mean to say, that satsanga is so powerful that it can never go in vain. I am not going to speak in details. Then next time, when Parvat Muni and Naraji Maharaj again coming that way, then that same couple, I mean the hunter and his wife, you know, jumping out from his bhajan kutir and, you know, cleaning the ground with cloth so that, you know, and paying prostrate dandavat to Naraji Maharaj, Gurudev, you coming, you know, I changed my life by your mercy. You know, why they are going to clean the ground when they are going to pray prostrate? Even one ant should not, you know, go down. You know, I mean the hunter never, one now don't want to kill even one cheti. Cheti mean ant. This kind of Vaishnavism coming inside him. Doing tilak, mala, everything, taking bath, Harinam, all continuously doing Harinam. Then, Mahaprabhu speaking to Sanatan, and from Skanda Puran, we know this incident, Skanda Puran, the how that cruel, how that cruel, hunter become Vaishnava, whereas you and me, I cannot become Vaishnava, because Kapat Bhav is there. Mahaprabhu speaking to, you know, Mahaprabhu speaking to Sanatan, the Sanatan, ete nahi adbhuta vedo tava hingstava ahingsa dayo gunaha, you know, hari bhakto pravritta je na teshu paratapinaha. Naraji speaking to that hunter, hey hunter, actually, hey bad, you are developing that kind of soft heart. He don't like to kill any creature, even ant, mosquito, nothing. Ete nahi adbhuta vyada tava ahimsa dayo gunaha. This kind of good quality coming inside you, non-violence, you know, this quality, complete non-violence. Is this kind of quality is quite natural. You are developing that kind of quality because Hari Bhakti Prabhritta Je Na Teshu Paratapinaha. Those who are starting Hari Bhajan, actual Hari Bhajan, they can never develop any envious attitude, never any fighting mood, never. They are not jealous with anybody. They are not going to express violence with anybody. So, ete nahi adbhuta, ete nahi adbhuta, vyadho tavahi, tava ahimsa dayo gunaha, hari bhakto prabhitta je na teshu paratapina. Those who are going to do harinam, harivajan, they can never develop that kind of violence mood. They always calm and quiet, very tranquil, very soft heart. They are so soft heart, say so soft heart, if they find one, you know, what to speak about Vaishnava. I like to give example so that you can feel shy. So I am going to give example which is out of Vaishnava area. You can remember Siddhartha who became Buddha Dev. Buddha avatar, two type of, one is Vishnu Buddha Dev. And Kapilavastu, they have Siddhartha, the prince of Kapilavastu. Follow, Shuddhodhan and Mata Mayadevi, Mayavati. He took birth there. He was prince. Only by watching three very painful condition in the society while going by his chariot, he was traveling, going somewhere. First he watched one very old man. He cannot, you know, arrange anything. Oh, useless. Second, one very beautiful pros, developed leprosy, Tamlaporni, he named. Third, another incident, I forget actually, a small boy, you know. After that, he take decision. This total is human life, this material world is unstable. Total unstable. There is jada, there is old age can come, you know, there can develop, you know, disease, inactive in future. So don't try to show this kind of attitude. If I develop that kind of attitude, if I find some old lady meeting with accident, if I am there, if I throw that lady, oh, I am Vaishnava, I cannot talk. This kind of thing I never learned from Guru Bhargava. Never. Never. In my whole life I never done this kind of thing. If I meet with this kind of accident, if people are going to throw me, then what will happen? Maybe today you are suffering, that lady or that, you know, man suffering. Maybe tomorrow I can meet with that kind of accident, and nobody can come. Then what will happen? Philo man feeling should be there. It is you know, minimum, you know, humanity should be there. Now that Buddha, one day in the afternoon time, he was, you know, he was sitting in the roof of the palace. There are some hunters with bow and arrow. He throw an arrow, and the throw and that arrow strike directly in the chest of that swan, hamsa, was flying. That hamsa, that swan was flying over that place, and the swan readily fall down in the rooftop, and Siddhartha running to the swan. Oh my God! Who is that cruel man doing this? You know. Then after that, taking out the arrow from the chest, and immediately call all, you know, servants, and they arrange medicine and everything, and he started taking gear, giving, you know, medicine, giving water and milk, everything. Swan. After some days, that swan was, you know, out of danger. Then Siddhartha make the swan free and let the swan fly in the sky. Externally, he was not Vaishnav. But that activities there are going to prove that the Vaishnavata, I mean, Vaishnavism is somehow, his Vaishnavism is there. You know, Haridas Thakur, all Muslim, you know, people, they are beating Haridas in 22 markets. Still Haridas speaking, okay, they are beating Prabhu, but still, it is my request to you, you know, please, you know, they arrange so that they cannot meet with Amangal. They don't know what they are doing. So Vaishnavism, sometime, not in full-fledged forms, secretly there inside heart, after that express, can get expressed, or maybe not this life, next life. And even in this human life, we find they are not Vaishnav, not Vaishnav. Like Mother Teresa, she was not Vaishnav, but still, she was feeling some sympathetic attitude for poor people, you know. This is one kind of karma. I am not going to give example in Vaishnav line, you should do it. What I am speaking, she used to take in lap poor, you know, small boys, this, that, and in there, it's one kind of seva, material seva. But I am Vaishnav, if I shout, why Maharaj giving this kind of example? To make you feel sigh. Why I am giving this kind of example? I need not give this example. There's countless example in my Vaishnav literature. I am giving this example to make you feel sigh. Maharaj, they are in such a condition, I am doing this way, so what is the great, what is the status of my bhajan? To make you feel I am giving this away. Never mind. So, Naraji Maharaj speaking to that hunter, he bath, this kind of non-violence attitude, very soft heart, is quite natural with the Vaishnava, those who are going to do bhajan of Hari. Because in that case you can see the whole world, what you think, what you do, what you speak, any things, any activities, all you are going to do in relation to Supreme Lord. You should not do any wrong activities. My Guru Padman used to say, Mahara, Baba, if one Jivatma feeling dissatisfaction, feeling pain for you have done some wrong, then you will have to suffer for that. You know, if that man is Vaishnava Paradi, automatically they can get punishment by Supreme Lord, we see. But that's I am not speaking. I can discuss about anartha, different kind of anartha, but today's discussion I think I cannot complete. So long discussion, you know. So Naraji Maharaj speaking to the hunt, you know, to the bed is quite natural. This kind of non-violence attitude, this kind of softness, this kind of, you know, very nice heart you are going to develop because of Hari Bhajan. Hari Bhakto Prabhritta Je Nate Shu Paratapinaha. They never give pain to others. You know. They never give pain to others. Kaya mano bakke kare udvega na dibe. It is applicable here. But pure Guru Vaishnava, when speaking so loudly, shouting and beating you, that is not violence. That is not jivhinsa. They love you very much. That's why they like to chastise you, beat you. They like to, you know, speak so heavily so that you can change your mood, negative mood. Follow what I say. So, don't try to take undue advantage of this word from Chaitanya Charitamrita. What I say, kai mano vakya kari udbeg na dibe. But I am going to take resolution that I am going to give you pain by body, speech and mind. Because I love you all. I like to change your heart. That's why I do. So my conception is not bad that I am going to do some jivhingsa, not that. But if I cannot speak all about the absolute, if you are doing some mistake, then I am sitting in Vyasasana, I'll have to suffer. If you are doing some mistake because you are hearing Harikatha, you accept me as Acharya. If you are doing, I become responsible. I have to suffer. My body become, I become sick. Follow this way. Try to, because I am thinking all the time, what problem, I am thinking. It's not good. So this way, kayamana vakya kare udbegna dibe, this you should apply in your own life, because those who are pure Guru Vaishnava Acharyas, they are going to rectify us by strong speech and, you know, treatment they are going to give. That's a totally different thing. It's not jivhingsa. I can quote another example from Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran. You can remember, fourth canto, you know. So many things already done by me. They are not going to publish. 4 months, almost four months ago, I complete Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, all everything, corona, virus, that writings and speech, everything, so many. But who is there to publish? Countless, almost countless. Anyway, by your mercy, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, who can take trouble, you know, so that you can know everything. There you can very carefully, you should hear. You can get exact guidance. I am not going to misguide you. That's why I am confident 100%. What is the target of Kali, you know? Be careful. Because we are going to do some more seva. We are trying. Our honest endeavor is to open big seva. But before that, I like to remind you that some days before, you can remember, I was speaking about Parikshit Maharaj there. You know, I was speaking. You can remember that day, only that day I was speaking. Abhartito tada tasme stanani kalaye dadau dutam panam striyaha suna jatra dharmo chatur vidaha. Tato anritam, after that, punoscho jacho manayo jato rupam adat prabhu. Tato anritam madam kyamam rajo vairancha panchamam. Amuni panchostanani hi adharma prabhavah kalihi uttarena dattani dattyani navasat tan nideshakit athaitani na seveto bhubushah purusho kachit visheshato dharmasilo raja loko patir guruh. Those who are honest king, those who are dharmic, pious king, those who are in a big, big sadhu, that's why they are not going to touch anything out of that five things. They are not. But still, Kali always searching opportunity. Kali always try to find one out inlet so that Kali can enter into your brain and make you puzzled and make fighting so that we cannot do any further seva. It is my request unto your lotus feet, everybody, all Matajis and Pitajis, everybody. It is my request unto all your lotus feet to be careful about that so that Kali cannot get any chance to get entry into your body and brain, to make you puzzled. Because it's a must, Kali is trying. So at the time of Prabhupada also, when Prabhupada tried to arrange some special bhajan place for Matajis, Vishnupriya Polli, you can go through Gauriya, long ago. Then after some time, there is problem. There is problem. Then Prabhupada, you know, Prabhupada giving, keeping hand on head. Oh my God, is the arrangement of Koli. I wanted to do so many nice things, but Koli cannot allow us to do. This way it is the target of Kali to upset everything. It is the target of Kali to upset everything. So you can start breaking, no making. That's why I was shouting that day, only breaking, no making, only breaking. You can break, no make. I was going to make one nice on a centrifugal force through which they can feel it very sweet relation and they can become very busy to serve Prabhupada, but in between you are breaking. If somehow, if you are going to give pain to somebody, going to break their heart by strong speech, you can also get in future. If you are not going to come out of aparat through the scientific procedure, then you also going to suffer. So you remember I was speaking, Parikshit Maharaj going to, because Kali asking place where to lick Maharaj give, then, you know, gambling, drinking, you know, wine, everything, intoxication, any kind of, Sriyaha, women, and in Gaudiya society also, Joshi Sangha is very fine, fine, innumerable, Shuna means Jibhingsa, everything. And also, when Parikshit Maharaj giving some more place to Kali, through gold and ornament, everything, and jewels, then Kali going to get comfortable place where Kali can reside very nicely. Because if gold is there, property is there, then artham anartham bhavayo nityam. It is Krishna Seva. Is okay, but usually you are not going to think that way. You think it is my property. You are collecting everything as a sannyasi acharya. You think it is my property, and my hereditary property. Who I like to show, become papta, you know, with vanity. So false ego coming. That's why Prabhupada told we need not go for enough, you know, sufficient money. We are not going to collect. According to the desire of Krishna we can get. So, athaitani na seveta, so pure sadhu, those who are interested to do bhajan and those who are pious kings, they should not take advantage of these five fields. You know, they should not go to contaminate them. They should not contaminate themselves by this kind of five factors. By this intoxication, you know, gambling. Sometimes it is one kind of gambling. He is collecting money, giving to businessman to get double. He is one kind of gambling. Sriyaha, woman, enjoying mood, and suna. Suna means jibhingsa. So in gold ornament or gold or, you know, jewels, everything, automatically Kali is there. So those who are pure devotees, they should be very careful to avoid those places, or at all they are going to handle with great care of yukta vairagya, so that no contamination can develop inside heart. If contamination done, then gradually, if with enjoying mood, if we are going to do satsanga or doing to do bhajan, then gradually we can get deviated and we can fall down. So satsanga cannot give us perfect result. This is the reason for why. I like to give you, so it is a, be careful about Kali. Those who are interested about bhajan 100%, they should develop so sensitivity, so accurate sensitivity, so that Kali cannot get any chance to contaminate our bhajan field. I was thinking for past two days, if this kind of thing we are happening in the beginning, then ultimately what can happen? Now I am going to take a great big step to do bhajan nicely with you all. But now in the beginning you are going to break everything. Then I think in future what will happen? I can throw. If you are not going to cooperate with me, if you cannot cooperate, you can go away. Don't make any disturbance. Still okay. But you are making the heart of devotees is very, very bad. They cannot get inspiration to do seva. So actually it is very, very offensive, very, very offensive. You should be very careful, you know. So we are going to do more and more seva, but in the beginning you are making problem. I can never expect, when I am almost successful to create a nice environment, in between you are going to, you know, you are going to open poison. I cannot excuse. I cannot excuse in future, you see, be careful. I cannot excuse in future. But I cannot tolerate if you are going to make any mistake with seva, because it's not a matter of joke. So I can give another example. So you should be very careful. It is my request about Kali. From different place, Kali can try to get entry. Even at all, any, you know, devotee want to help, I told that we can, you can maintain, it is not my duty, you can maintain accurate, you know, calculation so that we can submit there. It is my duty, you know, but I have no time. You'll have to do it. Any, even one penny somebody giving, it is our duty to show this penny you give, this expense. It is my resolution. If sometimes somebody going to do wrong, then you will have to get feedback for that. Anything, if they are giving seva, for this seva. So exactly for say, this seva we should use it, and we can maintain this account, this seva done. This amount can, we are not expecting, you know, all the time. Sometime if they are going to do at all, they are getting inspiration to do some seva, extend their helpful hand, they can do through some devotees, pure, you know, some devotees, those who are faithful, I think. So now it is my, and it is my duty to give you a reminder about the teachings of Shankar Bhagavan. Shankar Bhagavan, going to give one example, you can remember fourth canto, there one things happen. Shankar Bhagavan, Vaishnavanam Yathasambhu, you know, you remember, Nimnuganam Yatha Ganga Divanam Achyuta Yatha, Vaishnavanam Yathasambhu, Purananam Tuidam Bhagavatam. You remember this slok, Bhagavat slok, na? So, Nimnaganam Yathaka Devanam Chudeta, Vaishnavanam Yathasam. I mean, Vaishnav Shankar Bhagavan is topmost Vaishnav. Externally, he is taking the garment of non-Vaishnav, his uniform of non-Vaishnav, but actually he is Vaishnav. So, Shankar Bhagavan was there, it is written in Gita, Sthito Pragna. Sthito Pragna, who is Pragna? Pragna means gyan. You know, totally established in a fixed position, he can realize all full of Brahma everywhere, Bhagavan. No second identity. His sthita pragna, who can never deserve, who can never deserve his own doership, never. It's called sthita pragna. Sthita pragna. Follow. Sthita pragna, there are so many symptoms, I can again speak when I can start Gita explanation, I can try, by your mercy, by Guru Varga, I can try. So you see, Shankar Bhagavan was there in the assembly, and in the assembly, everywhere, everybody, all demigods, all Rishi Mani, Devi, everybody, Rishi Mani, they are sitting. In the meantime, Dakha Pajapati, who is popped up, you know, is full of vanity. So false ego. Oh, I am the leadership. I am getting the leadership of Paja. Subject, man, Paja. So he popped up. He is entering in the assembly. Everybody going to stand up and pay dandavat. Like in the school, teacher entering. Yes, sir, we get up. Then everybody should get up. But without Shankar and Brahma. Brahma not going to stand up because he is the... He is a creation, Brahma, creator, Adi Purush in our, you know, in this Brahmanda, you know, Brahma. So, Brahma not going to stand up, and, you know, Shankar Bhagavan is sthita pragna, topmost knowledgeable person. Not only that, his bhajan is topmost bhajan, his very, very important personality. Even Brahma going to fear Shankar. Even Brahma sometimes fears Shankar, because Shankar is so powerful. But Shankar is not going to stand up, and Brahma, except them, they too, except they too, everybody is standing up. Then Prajapati Daksha become very angry. Hey, it's my son-in-law. By the advice of Brahma, I was bound to give my beautiful daughter to this monkey. Hari, Markata Lochanaha. His eyes is like monkey. Oh my God. Sankar. Vaishnavanam yatha sambhu. Shiva Sankar. He's going to insult. Speaking all rubbish. You know. But while speaking all rubbish is speaking, I am not speaking out of jealousy. I am not going to criticize. This is the fact that he is my son-in-law. He should stand up. He's not going to pay dandavat, anything, stand up. No, no honor, son. It's not good. You know, he is going to break the rules set by all sadhu. He is not sadhu at all. He is useless, you know. And he is not going to maintain any purity. So again coming this question of purity. Shankar Bhagavan is not pure. I am also not pure because I was serving all the brahmachari stool, urine, everything. So I am not pure. Don't come to me. I am not pure. Really, I am not pure. You know, you are more pure than me. So this way you see, Shankar Bhagavan, he is going to speak. Hey, he is in a foolish number one, staying in, you know, in a crematorium ground, all using the stone, you know, the bone and everything, all useless. Chita bhasa sthana lepam is going to rub like powder, you know, all the dust, ash from the, you know, a funeral pyre going to apply his body. It's useless, no purity there. Oof, how foolish I am. I am going to keep my beautiful daughter, you know, Sati Devi. Sati, I only Brahma. Brahma ordered me, you should give. Oh, I have done a great mistake. You know, this monkey-like eyes. Then after that, there is altercation. There's big altercation began. Nandiya, Vrigu also, they participate. Then automatically, you know, big problem happens. After that, Shankar Bhagavan not speaking anything, keeping silence and coming back to his bhajan place and doing bhajan. Very shortly, Devi Maya, our Parvati Devi, going to speak to Shankar. Samin, there is so many, you know, demigods and everybody going to participate in their plan. Their chariot, they are going to participate in the Jagya, Brihaspati Sab Jagya, they are arranged by my father. So let us go. Shankar Bhagavan says, yes, we should go, but we cannot go. Why? This way he wanted to pick up some poor, unnecessary. I have no enmity with anybody. Actually, Shankar Bhagavan has no enmity with anybody. A Paramahansa can never have any enmity. If there is enmity, he surely is not Paramahansa. But Shankar Bhagavan singing Devi, actually Devi giving argument. Shankar singing is not, we are not invited. But so what? In the house of father, in the house of friend, in the house of guru, without invitation we can safely go. Shankar Bhagavan singing, yes, your argument is very good, right? But still we cannot go. Why? You know it very well. He is going to pick up some enmity, hostility with me, unnecessarily. I have no enemy. Actually, that time, I was standing mentally. Because Shankar Bhagavan was speaking, those who are Paramahansa, they are not bound to follow general rules, which you are going to follow in general in our society. Paramahansa doing everything, but mentally, inside heart. Shankar Bhagavan says, I already paid honor to him. He couldn't see. He is blind. Because out of false ego, he is blind. You know, that's why Dakha, this Dakha efficient. Daksha means, if I translate into English, it means actually efficient. Efficient, Prabhupada giving the exact meaning. And his name is Daksha, Daksha Prajapati. Daksha means is efficient. Efficient in material tax. He is always efficient in material dealing. He can, you know, do, he can run family life nicely, material arrangement, you know, profit and loss all. He is called Daksha, he is efficient. But he is not efficient in bhajan. He is material. He is so foolish, so idiot, so blind, he cannot see that Shankar Bhagavan is Vaishnavanam Jathasambhu, Paramhamsa. You should not insult him. But he is insulting. Shankar Bhagavan speaking, well, your argument is very good. But without an invitation, we can safely go to the house of, you know, father, house of Gurudev, you know, ashram of Gurudev, or in the house of, you know, our friends, place, we can go. But this case is totally separate. Unnecessarily you wanted to use, you know, slag language. Unnecessary. Okay, never mind. I never give answer to him. But this is impossible. They should not do it. Because I never have any enmity with him. But he is developing enmity. How I can go? Then Shankar Bhagavan giving to an argument to Shankar Bhagavan giving argument to Devi Maya, our Parvati Ma. Shankar Bhagavan, very minutely you should hear. Shankar Bhagavan, Jagat Guru, Shankar, speaking to Parvati Ma, mother, our mother. Tatha arivirna vyatate sile mukhai, shete arditanga hridayena duyata, swanam yatha bakradhiyam duruktivir, Diva Nishin Tappati Marmataritaha. We can apply this formula in the life of common people, in the life of Habbushna, because they cannot bear. Shankar Bhagavan never going to mind, but Shankar Bhagavan giving this argument to us to understand. But Mahaprabhu told us, Cheta Darpana Marjana, Bhava Mahatavak Nirbhav, everywhere forest fire. We are not. Just 2 days ago, 3 days ago, there was forester inside your house. I from behalf of, you know, fire brigade company, I was bound to run after Harikatha. You can remember? Now you are laughing, eh? Foolish, eh? I am fire brigade man. I am going to extinguish fire there, eh? Foolish. You know, now you see, Shankar Bhagavan going to speak. Tatha arivirna vyatate sile mukhai shete arditanga hidayena duyata. If somebody is, you know, going to strike somebody with very painful, you know, arrow or some very fine sharp weapon. Anyway, tatha arivirna vyatate sile mukhai. Some enemy going to try to kill me. He, you know, throw one bow or arrow or something, weapon. Somehow I was escaped, but somehow I was half, you know, danger was there. I take out, but the pain is there. But some I apply medicine, everything. But when I am going to take rest in home, suppose I am tired, when I am going deep into my deep sleep, then I cannot remember. The pain is there. Or maybe the first day I can pain 2 days. After that, the pain is coming down. Pain is not so heavy. In that case, I can sleep very nicely. And morning time when I get up, if the pose is wrong, then I am feeling pain again. That's different. But Shankar Bhagavan giving this example. Tatha arivirna vyatate sile mukhai shete arditanga hridayena duyata. Shanam yatha vakrodhiyam durukti vir divanishim tappati marmataritaha. If this way I am hurt by somebody, it is not so dangerous. If you are going to give pain, so flag language, I have no relation with you, you can go away, I can get contaminated. This way, that time their heart break down. They are feeling their soft heart going to give so much pain you give. So, you know, how they can sleep? Every time they can remember, oh, this way is, you know, not going, is not ready to extend helpful hand. So painful speech he spoke. This way, Shankar Bhagavan speaking, tata aravirna vyatate. If some enemy going to throw, you know, strike me with some weapon, okay, somehow I am feeling pain, but not so painful. If somebody going to speak all rubbish language, speaking with finger ends, you know, pointing out finger, you, in survey in America long ago, maybe 50 years back, there was a survey, which language everybody using most most frequent language, most frequently used word. I, me, this is a word. Telephone exchange, long before. So, tatha arivhirna vyathati sile mukhai shete arditango hidayana duyata. Okay, there is pain in my body, okay. But somehow I apply medicine and painkiller, everything, somehow I am out. But when you are going to give pain to some devotee who is not 100% devotee at present, when they are not doing any wrong activities, they always remember Guru Vaishnava. That in that sense, I told they are pure than me. That sense. They always think about Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan always, So if you are going to strike them this way with a strong word, useless word, heavy word, painful word, then how they can, take rest? You should think how soft their heart is. You are going to give pain to their heart. It's a great offense. You have to give nourishment to them so that they can never feel. You should think that I always think you all are my daughter and sons. Those who are, So this way, conception should be perfect. There should be no duplicity. So, Shankara Bhagavan speaking, who is going to speak all rubbish with, turned head is speaking all rubbish with, strong sight, speaking all rubbish. It is impossible. It is impossible to bear. It is giving pain day and night. Always coming in my, this. Also from Mahabharata, from someone the epics, Mahabharata. The Vidurji Maharaj, it is from the Vidurasya, Shubhasitani. It is from Vidurasya, Shubhasitani. All the Nectarian advice given by Vidurji Maharaj, I am quoting one out of them. Vidurji Maharaj speaking to Yudhishthira, it is written, the meaning I am speaking, Vidurji Maharaj speaking, that actually, Rohate Sayakair Vidham Banam Parsunahatam. Bacha duruktam vivatsam na sangrahoti bakakhatam. Bakakhatam means by your strong speech, if they develop some kind of, some skat, problem, more than blood. Vidurji Maharaj speaking, Maharaj, if I am going to take one sharp weapon and go, I am going to forest to cut all trees, catch, I am going to cut, Vidurji Maharaj giving this example, Rohote Sayakair Vidham Banam Parsunahatam. If I am going to take one cutter and going to forest to cut all trees, but someday those trees can get developed due to hormone. They can all again develop. But Bacha Duruktam, if some, notorious people, if some hooligan, if some demonic character is in the guise of sadhu, speaking all rubbish, or easily, bacha duruktam vivatsam. Vivatsam means useless, so heavy to bear, so painful, because common people, they cannot bear so much thing. Pure Vaishnavi can speak all slag language, they can laugh at it and go away, because not then that kind of strong language is not going to touch even their heart and mind, nothing. They are staying in a separate world. How they can feel sorry for that? How they can feel pain? Not that. Bacha duruktam vivatsam na sangrahoti bakakhatam. If somebody going to fire by the hail of mouth, speaking all fire of strong speech, and going to strike the heart of soft devotees, they cannot bear. How possible they are speaking this way? Where Rantidev, Prahlad Maharaj, they are crying, everybody, Prabhupada, everybody crying to give full nourishment to us all. we are feeling pain in this material world, and you are going to give fuel. And you know, there is forest fire itself. You are going to add some fuel so that the fire can, you know. I want to extinguish that fire. As a man, as a member from the fire brigade company, but you are going to arrange so that the fire can go more up and up. This is your duty, only breaking, no making. You cannot love anybody, you can give pain. If I speak all heavily to you all, heavily, but you can feel from heart, Maharaj speaking externally. Maharaj not going to give us pain. Maharaj love us so much, can speak this way. You have no love for anybody, only you can speak. Only you can speak heavy. Who can bear? You know? So, Mahabharat, I speak the teachings of Vidurji Maharaj, advice. Rohote sayakair vidhyam banam parsunahatam bacha duruktam vivatsam na sangrahoti bakakhatam. It is from Mahabharat. Another example I can give from Urdu, you know, literature. One very big professor of Urdu, he teaches this thing, you know, for Urdu language. Those who are knowing Urdu, they can laugh, they can understand. It is saying, you know, he teaches, Jarahatusyame lahaltiyamu wala yaltamu ma jarahal lasamu lesanu. You see, it's Urdu language, same meaning. Jarahatusyame lahaltiyamu wala yaltamu ma jarahal lesanu. So you see, it's same language. So even in Urdu language, those are Muslim people, they are also thinking. Some, no, they are not following, but still, in their language, you know, Sahitya is there. So this way, now I have no time to speak all in details. I always feel sorry. I cannot speak anything. I want to speak so many things, but I feel sorry. So I like to finish today with some, you know, conclusion. Next time, I can give detailed discussion about anartha and, you know, saranagati, all details, anukulla, all I can explain in details. So now I'm going to draw one conclusion. To construct your devotional life, it is not my speech, it is a speech of Prabhupada. To construct your devotional life, you know, 64 different kind of modes of bhajan, we should apply in your life, we should, you know, try, and especially nine folds of bhakti under the guidance of Gurupad Padma after taking perfect shelter. Not that usual dikha, dikha gone, dikha over, gone. No. Prabhupada speaking, to construct your devotional life, out of 64 devotional practices, your folds you will have to practice under the guidance of Gurupad Padma. Or if you are amenable, nine folds of bhakti, or maybe five, or maybe you can maintain your life so that you cannot develop any aparad, and ekango sadhe kimba sadhe bhavango, whatever duty given by Gurupad Padma you can do. Bhaktando, under the guidance means after taking full shelter unto the lotus feet of Gurupad Padma. Because Prabhupada speaking, without taking shelter unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, all your bhajan, maybe you can get up 3 o'clock. What it concern to me? I can throw you out. You can claim, Maharaj, I get up 3 o'clock. So to get more, more to increase your, you know, false ego. I get up 3 o'clock. They get up 5 o'clock. Useless. So 3 o'clock you get up. So what it concern to me? I like to see bhakti. Foolish, you know. Vairagya, you like to show me, austerity penances. Prabhupada speaking, without taking perfect shelter unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, all your sadachar, all your austerity penances, donation, tapasya, austerity penances, everything, japa, tapa, whatever you do, all useless. cannot give perfect result. Cannot give perfect result. Be careful about that. I can try to clarify this point all in details so that you can get no scope to misunderstand me. But still you are doing wrong. Repeatedly I am giving my blood to you. I am giving all my life and soul to you all. But still you are going to make mistake, so blunder mistake. You know, if you do great aparad, you cannot, life is very short. Life is very short. Repeatedly if you are going to make aparad, you cannot get any time to recover your bhajan. Be careful. At least if you are not going to do, you know, less seva, okay. You need not do. You go. Try to rectify your brain. But still it is my request that don't try to develop aparad. You can do less seva. Okay, you can do less seva. First of all, you have duty. You know, all duty you have to do. And after discharging your duty, you will have to do. If your heart is contaminated, then you are going to cook something. Somebody can take, they can also lose their consciousness. If you develop aparad gradually, then you are going in the kitchen, you can cook. Then after that, you are offering, Krishna cannot take. And you are, anyway, then after that, all people, then they can also lose consciousness. So one mistake there, we should rectify instant. We cannot give any chance to increase the problem, aparad. Because one problem is related to another problem. I can show you scientifically. If one problem, nothing, but that problem related to all problems. In temple, I know a direct example. You know, that Jalandhar devotee, one devotee there, he is doing seva, Bani seva also. He is speaking, Maharaj, I went to Madras for some purpose. I was bound to stay in temple. But there, after taking prasadam, I was burning, my heart burning. Oh my God, so chanchal I become. Oh, what happens? Never it happens in my life. But he took decision, what to happen? I never feel this kind of burning. Then after that, he took information that brahmachari doing archan and doing cooking, they are all rubbish, fallen soul, characterless. Follow. After that, he leave that place, pay money and leave that place. So if somehow there is aparad, we should eliminate immediately. We cannot give scope to increase the aparad. If not so, then one problem can give birth to another problem, one by one. Suppose one example, if that cookman is characterless, night time see, watching all internet now, you know, idiot is cookman and archan, which is the main place. Then all our devotees, how I can expect their character can be good? Follow, how we can expect their other devotees a chain reaction? If the archan is mistake, all we have to suffer. There is aparad inside temple, archan temple, I mean garbha mandir. Then everybody there in the goshti bhajan, they will have to serve. If they are characterless, that kitchen man, cooking man, then everybody they will have to suffer. Because they are taking. This way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that those who are acting as a spiritual leader, especially those acting as the acharyas, gaudiyas, they should try to rectify all the faults in the society. Otherwise, if they are going to indulgence, okay, indulgence, great Vaishnav there, they want to prove. Then day by day, we cannot stop the forest fire there in the spiritual field also. Also, who can stop? Everybody going to give indulgence or add fuel to the fire. This is the situation. So I like to stop today because I have some other seva. So you have to remember that how to avoid, you know, aparat, how to build up your spiritual life, this, and all the teachings of Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada I am speaking to construct your devotional life. Also those who like to develop and those who like to act as acharya, Prabhupada already told. Those who are, you know, automatically they can self-manifest it. For them, so the topics was, you know, so detailed, so I am bound to touch all those points so that you can understand that Acharya Tattva You can understand how we can rectify under the guidance of a pure Acharya. If Acharya is going to, you know, misguide us, going to, you know, misguide us, not going to speak all in details about that, then Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, all can get ruined. Paramhansa param paramatva patim patito dharane krita vesha jatim jati rajagunai parisebha padam panamami sada prabhupadu padam panamami sada prabhupadu padam panamami sada prabhupadu padam vanchakalpataru sikhe basindibhavisha patitanang pavana bhavishnabhyo namo namo.